Welcome back to my YouTube channel. As of what we have gone through in last week on Form 4, Physics, Chapter 3, on the introduction of pressure and the ability to look for pressure caused by fluid or water, where you have a pressure is H rho g, as well as I believe you have read through the theory. The theory kinetic gas, and also the application, how you want to make use of atmospheric pressure. And then towards the end of last week video, what would be the instrument for measurement, where you have a mercury barometer, a manometer that looks like a U-shape device, Borden gauge, as well as a aneroid barometer. Now this week, pretty simple, this week is where the calculation, another form of calculation, you get to learn three principles, chapter three principles. The first principle in form 4 chapter 3 is called Pascal, same spelling, Pascal's principle. Now in objective question it normally comes out, so it will be better you spend some time, I think 1-2 pages of your reference. There are three devices: hydraulic, how the hydraulic brakes in your car, you will use it, use this principle. Another one is a hydraulic jack that you will normally see in the mechanic shops. Hydraulic jack. This jack is different than from the one that you use in your car. It's a jack used in the tire shop or perhaps in the mechanic shop. And the last one is a hydraulic pump. Okay, you need to read on this. You may pause this video, read through it, the theory, and then resume this video. So how does it work? Yeah, it works as it says. Actually, what it says, the pressure that you apply, okay, the pressure exert that you apply, meaning exert on an enclosed, it has to be enclosed, yeah? You cannot have any leak or holes around it, otherwise it will leak, the liquid will leak, of course, enclosed liquid, yeah? It has to be enclosed liquid so that the pressure is transmitted, so the liquid is transmitted. Transmitted equally through the liquid. Through the liquid. So what are the keywords? So the keywords would be here: the pressure on the enclosed circuit equally through the liquid. So meaning they are not supposed to have any holes, not supposed to be any bubbles. Make sure it has to be no bubbles. No bubbles trapped in between liquid. There's no holes. Okay, in the enclosed chamber. Okay, now let me give an example for hydraulic pump. Maybe the better way for you to know of this principle would be to have this diagram in your mind. Very much look like the manometer, the U shape. Okay, one side is smaller than the other side is wider. Obviously, left side is smaller, the area on the right side is bigger. So what happened? There's going to have a piston, or maybe a piston perhaps. You may push it down, and maybe here would be another platform. Okay, you are going to fill this with liquid, hydraulic liquid. Make sure there's no hole, no bubble trap. Otherwise, the pressure exert will be used to compress the bubbles before being able to push this piston from the other side, from going out. So you get some loss of power. So what happens if you apply force? Eventually the piston over this side will go up. It's obvious, right? Now what it says here, okay, here is F1. The area one here is I would label as area one. Cross-sectional area, yeah, this cross-section area, this cross-section area. Whereas over this side, this area is larger, obviously, and the force exert up would be F2. Okay, now in Pascal principle says, law it says, the pressure exert on enclosed is transmitted equally. Okay, this is the word, transmitted equally, meaning the pressure down, P down, equals to P up. Okay, I'll put it this way, put it here. It means P1 on the left is equals to P2, provided that there are no leakage. Okay, no leakage. So here, yes, you may argue, I mean, you will say, oh, why there's liquid, but then it is supposed to be H-log-G. No, you do not use H-log-G because this liquid do not actually contribute to the pressure, but the external force over the area is going to cause pressure. So therefore, this equation would be pressure is force per area from my first video. Therefore, will be equal to F2 over A2. So if you've gone through my chapter 2 video, so force is actually mg, yeah, mass times gravity. That's basically what you will get. So if you were to use this equation, says another scenario, now hydraulic pump, okay, I'm going to have a car, okay, I want to raise a car, okay, maybe I put an object, not a car yet, I mean put an object to raise it. Okay, all right. You have liquid. Yeah. Okay, so the amount of force that you put in over this area, the pressure will be transmitted equally and it's going to provide F2 pushing up over area A2. So if I give you some dimension, some value, say for example, the area of it is maybe 20 Newton. The area here is says is 2 centimeter squared. Then the area here you were able to measure is normally constant for a device 50 centimeter squared. So you will ask, what is the force of F2? So it's always good if you come across with this kind of question, you sketch this diagram and it helps you to understand F1 and F2, which is the input, this is the output. So all you do would be F1 over A1 is equals to F2 over A2 because the pressure has to be the same. So if you want to find out F2, what you do, you bring up A2. So therefore, no, F2, therefore F1 over A1 you times A2. And the value, you want to convert it, therefore is 20 Newton over A1 area is 2 centimeter, so that will be 2 times 10 minus 4. Right? Because centimeter to meter squared to be SI unit, times area 50 times 10 minus 4. Okay? So put in a calculator, Newton. Therefore, the answer that would be 500 Newton. Okay, now if you compare the amount of force you put in, just now earlier you only need 20 Newton, but you were able to lift 50 newton of load. Isn't it amazing how many times it is? The ratio is 500 over 20. That would be 25. 25 times. That's hydraulic jack. The same is true with hydraulic brakes and as well as hydraulic jack. Okay? That's amazing. Okay, maybe from your reference, yeah, it's a matter of rearrangement. Yeah, they ask you to memorize this. Actually, it doesn't need to memorize, just understand it, and this is what you get. Separate occasion, what they normally do? It says what output or input, output or input. Yes, output or input. Maybe we'll say F2 output over input is equals to output over input. Then isn't it the same? Isn't it the same? Just bring it down, just bring it up, they exchange places, and therefore they give you another something for you to memorize, or what memorize is what output over input. And then you memorize this so hard. Why you want to memorize it? So do not memorize any equation. All you need to do is to understand this concept. Okay? The physics of it will be the first line. If you understand this one, then shouldn't be any problem. The pressure over the left equals the pressure over the right. What is pressure? Pressure is force over area. You just need to believe it. And then you will go. This is how you do it. Try not to memorize this equation from any other reference or books. Yeah. So you may pause this video, of course. You may read through the application, as I mentioned earlier. Hydraulic brakes, hydraulic pumps, hydraulic jacks, etc. Okay? You may pause this video or proceed with the next principle. Okay, let me show you the next principle. That would be second principle for form 4, chapter 3, they call Archimedes. Okay? Archimedes principle. So, in order to help you, yeah, to really understand, so helps you to identify, because there are some other theory and theorem in other chapters. So, first way to help you understand, first thing, what's Archimedes? Archimedes is all about floating. Or in this text, they use buoyancy force, or buoyant force. Yeah? We call buoyant force, meaning it floats. Why is it floats? It floats because it has a buoyant force going against you from the water. Okay, so how it comes about? Okay, someone called Eureka. Okay, they call Eureka Cup. It went to take a bath, if I'm not mistaken. It found that the amount of water displaced from the bathtub, the weight of the water displaced from the bathtub, is the same as the weight of the human. Okay, so that's the story behind it. I'm sure you have heard of it. If it doesn't, then maybe it's the first time you heard of me. To put it into a more scientific way or words, that would be the object. Okay. I'm going to draw you a picture also later to help you to memorize it. Object, object immersed. Immersed in fluid or water. Fluid is anything that will feel the shape. And buoyant force. Egg on it, and is equal, the buoyant value, yeah, buoyant force value is equal to the weight of the fluid displaced. Take some time to comprehend it. I will let you go through it, immerse in fluid, a buoyancy force act on it, and the force value is equal to the weight of the fluid displaced. Okay, you may think of when you have a cylinder tube where water is filled up to the brim. Okay, so what happened when you were to put in or immerse a stone onto it, and then water will be displaced from the cylinder? And if you go to measure the amount of water displaced by the stone, the weight will be equal to the value for the buoyancy force. Okay? Where will you be? What's the application? Yeah? What do you need to read on from your book? Highlight. Okay? Where will it be? First of all, go for submarine. How does it work? It's based on this. Or hydrometer, used to measure the specific gravity for water in the aquarium. Or ship, yeah? Need to read through the application. Okay, so what's the diagram? Helps you to understand it better. So you have a Eureka cup, yeah? Okay. Okay, this cup is very special. Okay. Maybe. Okay. Alright. Now, if you were to fill water up to where? To here. I mean, just before. Okay. Just before it comes out. And of course, you need to have a small cup, so that you'll be able to measure the water displaced later. What happens if you have a stone or any object tied to a string? Okay. What happens when you immerse it into the Eureka cup? Next moment, it's not that it becomes smaller, okay? No way it becomes smaller. It's that I want to save some time on it. I want to draw it fast. Then the water here, water will be displaced. Okay, some amount of water, isn't it? Now, the amount of water displaced is same as with the magnitude of the buoyancy force. So this is what it meant. Okay? Or, to put into words, if you want to find out the, if you go measure the weight of the stone in air, okay, in the air initially, okay, it will be equals to the would be the weight of stone in water. It will normally be lighter, plus the apparent loss in the weight of the stone. So here, meaning initially, if you were feeling, use a finger, I mean your finger, try on it, finger. It's very heavy. But this word to be immersed to hear what happened, you find that it is lighter than earlier. Why is it lighter? Because there is a buoyancy force hang on it. Okay? So this is apparent loss in weight of the stone, which is equal to the amount of the loss or the displaced water. This one is here. This is the weight of stone in water, so this is what you get. How you get apparent loss of weight in water? You measure the weight of the water and you will get. Okay? And this is value. This is where the buoyant force. Okay, the weight of the fluid displaced. So there are a few examples you may go through in your from your reference. Okay, how the ship application and submarine, hydrometer, or the Cartesian divers. Maybe I'll give you an example. Example for in the next page, perhaps. Now, you have an object or styrofoam initially immersed in the water. Whereby the water level is about, say, 0.6 meter. Okay, the area, okay, the area, okay, this area, perhaps, okay, the area is 1 meter by 1 meter. Next moment, the same cuboid, I mean the side view now, I think it's better to put in the side view. Now, see in a small child. Then of course, for to be sure, is that the water level should be now higher. Than from initial, 0.6. And now the water level is now 0.8 meter. Okay, so you are asked to find out the weight of, maybe you ask, first they ask you to find out the weight of the object on the left. How, what's the weight? Okay, now in this case it's pretty actually straightforward. Okay, here the weight of the object is actually the amount of water displaced. These are the amount of water being displaced. Right, this square amount of water being displaced. The amount of displaced water from my previous slides or previous page, amount of water displaced is actually the buoyant force. Now, okay, come back to here. Buoyant force is the apparent loss, meaning the amount of, or the volume, or the mass, or the weight of the displaced volume. Okay, so the weight of the object is equals to the weight of the displaced water. So over here, how do you do that? Okay, now you may confuse with your previous equation, because weight of it would be rho vg. Why is that so? Why is it different? You may confuse. Why is that so? Because from density is actually mass per volume. So if you want to find out what's mass, mass would therefore be rho v. Then what about g? G is gravity, so that you will get to know what's the weight. Please don't confuse this equation with the pressure caused by fluid. It's different, yeah? So if you have that, yeah, if you manage to find out the weight of displaced water, rho vg, therefore you put in the equation. Well, of course, density is water is 1,000 kg per meter cube. So therefore, it's 1,000. Volume is 1 by 1 times 0.6. 1 by 1 times 0.6 meter times, this is 10 meter per second squared, Newton. Okay? So it's therefore 6,000 meter. So what's important here is not about the calculation. What's important here is the ability to identify, okay? The weight of this object, how do you determine it? Is by the displaced water, weight of displaced water. Okay? Find out what is the displaced water, displaced fluid. For a hot air balloon, then it will be displaced fluid. Okay? So here, now you are asked to find out how about the weight of the human. Okay, now here, weight of the human. What's the weight of the human? Before 0.6, after human, so there's an increase of 0.2 meter. So this increase of 0.2 meter denotes this is extra or additional. This is called the additional amount of water being displayed after the human stands on it. So therefore, it will be so straightforward, isn't it? So therefore, the weight of the human will be, again, rho vg. What is rho? Rho is again 1,000. V, what is V? V is 0.6. Oh no, sorry, it's not 0.6. Weight here is 0.2 times 1, right? Volume times 10, Newton. Therefore, 2,000 Newton. Wow, that's what human would be, 2,000 Newton. Okay? So it's not about the mathematics, it's about the ability we'll be able to identify, okay? Or transform into equation. Additional amount of water displaced is always displaced. Volume amount, or the amount of water displaced. You got to make use of this equation to find out the mass. Okay? The same is true with some hard question. You might want to think of it where you have hot air balloon, then you have a basket, okay, tied on it. Okay? Whether it's floating or not is subject to question. Where it is static, meaning go up and down, is the same, Right, so total mass down mg, same as with the amount O-U-N-T, okay, amount of air displaced. Okay, so you need to assume it to be a square, so therefore sphere is 4 over 3 pi r cubed. So you need to know the equation for a sphere, assume it to be a sphere, then you times the density, then you know the amount of air displaced. Then you times it in, then eventually you get to know what's the force going up and coming down, how much of it you need, so that this hot air balloon will be staying up high in the sky, not accelerating up nor down. But of course it's up and down, then you need to go to my chapter 2 video study on free body diagram. Yeah, whether it's go up or down, you need a free body diagram to solve those questions. That's the application that you will need to think of it. But it normally comes out in objective question. Okay. Then the last principle. The third principle. The last principle is called Bernoulli. Bernoulli principle. Is there any equation? Not really. There isn't much equation about it, so that's good news. So what Bernoulli says? Bernoulli says high speed, low pressure. High speed, low pressure. That's all about it. Okay, high speed, low pressure. Okay, or you put it into easier. I mean, put it into a. This is a high speed, low pressure. Maybe you don't really understand what's going on. Then okay, you will say the pressure of the fluid, whether it's air or water, decrease. When it decreases, when the velocity of the fluid increase. Okay, where will it be? First, I mean the easiest one would be the airplane, the shape of an airplane. I mean the airplane shape. Okay, the plane, cross-sectional view. Cross-sectional wheel before it connect to the fuselage. Okay, you have this curve, right? So if you view it from cross-sectionally, what happened? Air traveling against the air, isn't it? Normally that's how the aircraft travel. So what happened is when you pass through the wind, what happened? Glide through the wind on the top will follow this profile, whereas the one here will follow straight, isn't it? Travel straight. So what happened here and here, the pressure here will be decreased, isn't it? Because the air will need to travel faster. The air on top will travel faster, so they will come back, meet here. Whereas here, just straight line. The displacement here is greater, right? So you need to travel faster so that you both of the particle will reach up to here at the same time. Okay? And because of that, pressure down as compared to here. Here is pressure up, higher, isn't it? Pressure higher, what happened? Therefore, you have a lifting force. So that you lift up the fuselage or the cabin of the airplane. Another example is, I think most of us will have experience carrying umbrella, or you have seen this kind of condition. After school, you go against the wind is from left to right. What happened? pass through here down. As compared to the one here, is go straight. What happened? High speed, low pressure. As compared to here, what happened? High speed, low pressure. You're going to have lifting force. The next moment, your umbrella, poor umbrella. Right, this is what will happen. Okay, next moment. Okay, so this is an example for Bernoulli. Okay, you may read through your text reference on the application. First application would be Bunsen burner. There's a small hole. This is called aerofoil, okay? Aerofoil, Bunsen burner, or it would normally comes out in an objective. Insecticide, sprayer, high speed, low pressure, hydrofoil, aerofoil, hydrofoil, those are the keyword. Look at it, hydrofoil, aerofoil, Bernoulli, no doubt. Okay. Also, football, kick on one side, rotate faster than the other. High speed, low pressure, higher pressure, go to lower pressure, that's why it would push the ball towards another direction. Also, you need to read on to the fluid. Fluid in the tube. Okay? Go to three condition. The height, yeah, which one is higher than the other? It's always fast. When the water is travel very fast, then low pressure. Okay? I think it's good to illustrate here. I mean, you have three pipe. So this is what I try to mend. Water goes in from here to here. What happened is high speed, low pressure. Okay, so here would be the scenario. Now, initially, water flow in here. When from big area to small area, the AA, the speed of the water will be high. Therefore, the pressure here will be very low. Atmospheric pressure, ATM, therefore is higher than here. So therefore, you will push it downwards. So therefore, it's going down. Okay? All right? Here, you have high pressure. Here is higher pressure of liquid. This is higher. This is just high pressure. That's why it's in between. This is highest, second highest. This is the lowest. Of course, you put the other way around, then you just need to invert the concept. Okay. You need to read on the application. It's always high speed, low pressure. That's all for this video. Do subscribe to my YouTube channel. Like my video if you wish to. Stay tuned to my next video in the following week. Thank you.